Championship Wrestling for 10 years, providing excellence and innovation in virtual wrestling. Up here, but this music that I'm very familiar with, that you're very familiar with, has just interrupted Sasuke. And arriving to the ring is a man that has taken ACW by storm these past couple days and weeks, the general manager's assistant of ACW Impulse, the one and only Lelouch Lamperouge. Lelouch is going to head of the ring here. He was the man that made the triple threat match happen for the Impulse title at the Royale Rumble. And this, I believe, will be Lelouch's first public meeting with the Impulse champion. And Sasuke is right. Zuko is not in the building. it in here. Lelouch has the mic. Basically letting Sasuke know that we are getting close to the season end here, and that he may want to be able to do what he has to do to retain that Impulse Championship should he be able to get through the Royale Rumble heading into Animania 5. Whew, what an intense opening there, folks. I am Hawking Johnson, as I just stated, your ACW commentator, and it's going to be a wild, wild ride here tonight. We will find out if Zuko and Sasuke can get along here tonight. Impulse number 96. Zuko still has not arrived in the building here for his main event matchup later on tonight. I don't know if that match is still going to happen as a tag match or it's going to be a handicap match, but nonetheless, this is still scheduled in the main event. Kankuro and Gaara will take on Sasuke and Zuko. I have not heard from Zuko, and I don't know if Sasuke didn't even have a partner for this match. Also tonight, Dark Magician will put his Intercontinental title on the line in this open challenge that will be continuing. Who will take the challenge? We have no idea. But coming up next, it is an opening cruiserweight contest here as Goten is 1-on-1 against Davis right now. You see Davis make his way out to the ring here. It has to be noted that Davis and Goten are both going to be a part of the 20-man Impulse for the match coming up at the Royal Rumble less than 2 weeks. Let's take you back to last week on Impulse number 95. Goten defeated Dennis 1-on-1, but that wasn't the story. Afterwards, Goten would grab a chair and assault Dennis repeatedly. Davis would come out to save his young brother here and wipe out Goten, a man that has been taking advantage out of everything these past couple of weeks, not just on those two, but anybody that Goten finds an issue with. So Darius was able to save Dennis from any further assaults. And now Davis tonight here will want to take care of the Prodigy. That we're in Michigan and this song plays and this is the only time it would get booed. That's only because this man's getting coming out. It's only because this man's coming out here. The quote-unquote Prodigy. A man that has just been on a tyrant raid as of late. A guy that has just been taking advantage of everything he sees fit. Taking actions upon himself. And I don't know if it's just to be against his father Goku, who isn't here tonight, that Lelouch is running Impulse before Rumble. I don't know if it's because it's against his father's wishes, or because he just feels like doing it. But Goten is somebody that needs to be pulled down, he needs to be humbled. Because if he keeps doing this, he is going to end up the way that his brother did Gohan did. But I think Goten doesn't care, I think he feels that he's just better than his brother, and he surely feels that he's better than his legendary father. I don't know where it's coming from. Nonetheless, the bell is rung and here we go. Goten versus Davis in the opening contest here. And Davis not wasting any time. Going after the leg. Kicks him down. Now, if I'm Goten, I wouldn't be playing and wasting time with Davis. Clotheslines Goten over the top rope. And that could very well be what happens to Goten after the Impulse from a match in less than 2 weeks. Now, Davis going after Goten outside here. Take a look at this bit of offense here to start things off. Davis kicking the leg of Goten there. Kicking his leg out of his leg, under his leg, from above the leg, right towards the leg. That's right, biatch, I said that. And Goten, oh, with a springboard drop kick. And that might have been able to be what the doctor ordered here. Look at this! Goten only able to get a two. Goten will take advantage. Earlier this week, it was known that the likes of Monkey D. Luffy, Cell 13, Solid Snake, Neji Ayuga will have all declared for the Impulse Rumble match. So they will all be competing at the Impulse Rumble match, the 20-man Impulse Rumble match at the Royale Rumble in Chicago. Contrast to the historic 30-man Excel Rumble match, to where the winner of that match will become the Excel champion right then and there. On the Impulse side, who will be able to grab the golden ticket to compete for the Impulse Championship at Animania 5? And look at that! Don't tip with a nice high elevated moonsault onto Davis. Here's a quick cover. Shoulders are down. Two. No. Take a look at this again. Look at the slow motion here. Perfect moonsault. Right on top of Davis. We're back live here in Goten now. Going for a bit of a chin lock towards Davis. Davis, one of the more proficient technicians in ACW. He's going to look to try to escape here. And going back to what happened before the commercial break, Sasuke Uchiha is willing to fight this handicap match with Kankuro and Gaara should Zuko not show up. And I think Zuko will find every way possible to just kind of play with Sasuke before that triple threat match for the Interpulse Championship coming up at the Rumble. As Davis is trying to make a comeback here, going after Goten. There's multiple kicks up, Goten able to counter that offense there. Goten misses the attack. Nope, Goten. Puts Davis to the ropes here. And nope. Oh wow, punched right to the kidney. And Davis, with a nice dragon screw, takes down Goten. Now what's this here? Look at this. Tries a nice wrist lock here. Goten able to escape. And the former Cruiserweight Champion able to escape that motion. Goten from the ropes here. Clotheslines Davis! And now Davis is the one set over the top rope. little bit of a little bit of imagery there for both Davis and Goten, as Goten waiting on the apron here, going for some sort of maneuver here. Oh, man, from the ropes here, and Davis moved out the way, and Goten crashes and burns to the outside. And that could have very well have cost Goten the momentum here against Davis. And now Goten from the ropes here to the outside, and another drop kick sends Goten back. Excuse me, sends Davis back. Goten from the ropes here. Davis able to counter. Shoulders down by Davis onto Goten. There's a two. And no. And there's a nice enziguri. Or a Pele, excuse me. And Davis might be able to control the narrative here. He was dragging Goten to the middle here. Look at this. Kick right to the back. Oh, another one. You can hear that echo all around this arena. And for Davis, he's just trying to get redemption and retribution for his brother. And it's crazy how Davis has changed his attitude compared to the start of the season, where he had wanted nothing to do with Dennis. And now here he is defending his brother's honor against Goten, as Goten kicks Davis's leg under, elbow to the face. Goten, as the crowd here in Grand Rapids are cheering Davis on here. Neckbreaker, no! Oh, man! And there's the roaring elbow. One, two, three. Oh, man, no! And I think Davis can't believe that. Take a look at this again. That roaring elbow from behind to the back of Goten's neck. So back live, and now Davis will have to recuperate here. And look at this. Throw over DDT. No! Goten able to counter it with that snap arm wringer. And now goes on top of the turnbuckle. What's he going to do here? That's what I thought he was going to do. The Prodigy Press! One, two, three. No! And only a three. Only a two. Match continues. Davis with a big elbow. Good back and forth between two cruiserweights. One of them being a former cruiserweight champion in Goten. He's looking to reach back to the top of the mountain there. And now Goten has Davis up. Oh, man! Just drops him on top of the turnbuckle pad with the snake eyes. He's going to capitalize here. And a corkscrew moonsault by the Prodigy! Cover shoulders down to Goten is victorious over Davis. Take a look at this in slow-mo again, a corkscrew moonsault of epic proportions. Davis was game and fought Goten to the nail. But Goten is victorious here tonight on Impulse 96. He will take momentum heading into the Impulse for the match. And Davis might need some help here. He looks like he's really... Wait a minute, what's Goten planning here? Wait a minute. Come on, you won the match. Come on, let's not do this again. Can the referee do so? Oh, come on! Come on, what the hell is this? And there's Dennis, who was saved by Davis last week, helping his brother. Oh, my God! And Dennis gets another chair shot for his troubles. And the referee got it. What the hell is this? Can someone get Goten the hell out of here? And there's Trunks! Trunks going after Goten here! And a clothesline sends Goten over the top! Trunks has business with Goten that is not finished! And Goten, get him the hell out of here! He doesn't want any problems with Trunks! He wants no beef with Trunks whatsoever! What a coward! But Trunks able to prevail and save Davis and Dennis here tonight! But I can tell you that this is far from over between these two! We'll be right back. Goten is starting out as number one in the Impulse Rumble match. Well, you're welcome. Well, the Cruiserweight Champion Roy will make his way out to the stage here with correspondent James Gibson. And we are going to all await the answer that Aaron Yeager laid out last week. Will we get the rematch for the Cruiserweight title? Let's listen in. Yes, I am rolling with this. Holy crap. We're getting Raw Era 2 next week for the Cruiserweight title. Oh my God, that's going to be an epic match. And I cannot wait, just as much as you cannot wait. The Cruiserweight title continues to be raised up in the stakes and levels of greatness. But still to come tonight, Kankuro and Gaara will team up to take Sasuke and Zuko. Again, I still have not heard from Zuko. We don't know if Zuko's going to even show up at this point, but that is still scheduled for the main event. But coming up next, Dark Magician will defend his Intercontinental title in an open challenge. Who took on the challenge? Challenge. Who is the opponent? Oh man! I haven't heard this song in a while! And I haven't seen him in a while! The demented Hiei has stepped up to the plate and will be Dark Magician's open challenge opponent tonight for the Intercontinental title! I gotta be honest, I didn't think he would be one of those people to take the challenge head on. The last time we saw Hiei was at ACW Victory, where he lost to a third time to Sasuke Uchiha for the Impulse Championship inside that steel cage. And we literally have not seen Hiei since. We have not heard a word from him and his whereabouts. And here he is tonight, to go after ACW title gold once again. as Sasuke Uchiha, and as other fans with ACW have stated before, he has always went up to the dream. He has always challenged within the big time situations, and has always faltered. Dark Magician is on a roll so far. Can he actually be the one, after a few weeks of absence, stop the Dark Magician hype? This will be interesting. The Intercontinental Championship is on the line. And for Hiei, he is looking to win his first ever singles title in his ACW career. And as I just stated, the Dark Magician is looking to cement his legacy and to cement his status as the greatest Intercontinental Champion of all time. There's the title beautifully raised up high over the referee here, as we are going to get set for this title matchup right now. Bell is rung, here we go. He ain't telling Dark Magician, let's go. Yumoto on the bottom right there. And look at that, here we go, Dark Magician taking advantage of Hiei's distraction. And look at this now, Dark Magician. Hiei up, looking for a vertical suplex, and Hiei able to escape! And now literally escapes! Hiei able to escape from that vertical suplex attempt that you'll take a closer look here. Hiei, not off to a great start here as we're back live. And Hiei is going to look to play mind games with the Dark Magician, but Dark Magician has Yugi. So Magician will be well aware of Hiei's intentions throughout this match. Here we go, front face off by Hiei, knee blocked there. Yanks down the arm. Hiei misses that lariat. And a big swing and neck breaker by the champion. And look at this, nope. I think Hiei was going to get a scoop slam, but Hiei able to, from behind here with the pin, shoulders down, two, and a kick out. Look at that, a sweeping clothesline by Hiei. Another pin attempt, one! And a shoulder up at one here. And I can see that Hiei continues to try and go for a cover each and every single time that he can. Yeah, see, look at that, look at this. Cover, one, two, and another shoulder up by the Magician. Hiei is forcing Magician to kick out in all these situations. He is desperately trying to win the Intercontinental title and is not wasting any time to pin Magician every single opportunity. Cover. One. Two. And once again, Magician able to kick out. And he is starting to get flustered here. And he once again distracted by Yugi. Clothesline by Magician, but did not connect. And another shoulders down roll up here. One. Two! And Magician escapes! Hiei is desperately trying to get the pin here and get the hell out of Grand Rapids as the new Intercontinental Champion. And I gotta be honest, it's a pretty smart strategy. Magician, when he gets into second gear, is damn near unstoppable. So for someone like Hiei, he wants to be able to pin Magician quickly and out of nowhere. As Hiei up here, big vertical suplex, finally looks for it. And oh wow, look at this. One, two, and he able to kick out, and that was a little bit of an arrogant pin there by the Magician. Don't know if that was really necessary to do there, but it is what it is. And a back suplex onto Hiei. Dark Magician went for a clothesline. Hiei able to counter it with a nice swinging neck breaker. And now Hiei, going up top, not wasting any time. Down the frog splash from the top turnbuckle. One, two, and a shoulder up. Take a look at this again. Magician with a big back suplex. Missed the clothesline there. Hiei able to counter with a nice rolling neck breaker. And then look at this. Big frog splash from the top turnbuckle. Went for a cover, but was only able to the other two. He is basically sprinting against Magician, but Magician's still able to stand tall, no pun intended, and he's still able to stay alive in this match. And now Magician will have Hiei up here for another vertical suplex attempt. And Hiei once again escapes that. And now Hiei, wait a minute, German suplex, no! Magician with an elbow. Big elbow to the back. Hit to the midsection. And now what's this Magician has Hiei down here. Magician gonna run up here and puts his entire weight onto Hiei. And look at this! Mikinoku driver! Dropped it on his head! The counter, one, two, three! Oh my god, no, Hiei with the shoulder out. Take a look at this again. Drops his entire weight onto Hiei, counters it, and capitalizes with a nice Mikinoku driver. But even that barely got a two. Back live here, Magician working on the neck of Hiei. Hiei, I gotta be honest, he's been pretty impressive on his return back to Impulse, but Magician's giving him a fight. This is for the Intercontinental Championship. And Hiei with a kick to the face of Magician. Lucha arm drag takes down the champion. Drops an elbow. Now Hiei taunting the crowd here. Hiei losing focus on the champion. He might want to focus where his priorities are if he wants to become the new Intercontinental Champion. Front face lock by Hiei here. Drags him away from the ropes. Dragon screw sends down Hiei. Hiei sends down Magician. Now look at that. Wisely working on the leg of Magician, knowing that that is part of his arsenal. And Yugi's getting a little bit worried for his monster. And knowing Hiei, if you know the history of ACW, the man will do whatever it takes to win. He will do whatever it takes to be a champion. And another forearm from the middle rope. Cover. Could this be the end of the Magician Intercontinental title reign? Not just yet. Not just yet. And he is really getting a little angry here. A little, excuse me. He's getting a lot angry, getting big mad. But Magician's still in the fight. And now Magician, gonna have Hiei up here, gonna go for another vertical suplex attempt here. And Hiei, once again able to escape from it, goes for a roll-up crucifix, shoulders are down! Magician, can he be able to escape the roll-up here? Yes, he does! But Magician's title reign continues to be at risk every time Hiei nails a surprise roll-up out of nowhere. Hiei continues to fight here. Ah, oh, there's a knee right in the face! In the face! And now Magician's bleeding, but Magician from behind drops Hiei with the neck breaker. Magician trying to showcase that he is the greatest Intercontinental Champion in ACW's history. And Hiei is trying to sabotage those efforts. As Magician, big vertical suplex. And Magician may be looking to put an end to Hiei's chances here. Nope, Hiei counters it with a fireman's carry from the ropes here. Leaping, nope, drop kick does not counter there. Kick to the midsection. Desperation DDT in the middle of the ring. Magician going for the cover. Hiei's down. Magician has retained the title. No, he hasn't. Oh my god, what an intense Intercontinental title match we're witnessing here at Impulse number 96 here tonight. Magician's doing everything that he can to keep that title within his waist. But Hiei is looking at every possible outcome to threaten Dark Magician's title reign. And now Hiei sent to the outside. Hiei trying to gather himself. Wait a minute, wait, no way. Magician's gonna try to fly here? Oh my god, Magician gonna go fly. No, Hiei went back inside the ring here. Hiei looking like a freaking starter. Holy crap. Hiei scouted Magician's attempt there. And did it with great justice. Blocks the punch. Magician, Black Magic Cutter to BMC onto the challenger. With just put away his opponents with ease. 2, 3. Oh my God. Oh my God. He just got the shoulder up at 3. Tailless again. Magician tried to go flying, but he was able to negate it with a Frankensteiner. But Magician will counter back with a BMC, and it still did not put away the challenger. We are back live at what an Intercontinental title match you are witnessing here tonight. He ain't trying to fight back. No way. Can he do it? Oh my God. No way. That is a big man he's carrying. There's a third eye. Third eye by Hiei. We've got a new Intercontinental champion here. Oh my God, Magician with a shoulder up. Woo. Pele. Hiei going up top. Another frog splash. He's got the cover. Shoulders down. Magician didn't see it. Oh, he kicked out again. Holy crap, I am losing my voice. But what an Intercontinental title match. He is fighting tooth and nail. And Magician is doing everything he can to retain the title here in Grand Rapids, Michigan. Something's got to get here. Forearm missed from the middle rope. And now Magician, German. Oh my God, bridges it. Can you believe this? 1, 2. Oh, he got kicked out of 2. Oh my God, what a match. And now Magician whips it to the corner. Well, let's pay off your Magician. Big clothesline. Runs the Bulldog. Down goes Hiei. And it might be time for Dark Magician to put away here. Wait a minute! Wait a minute! Neji Ayuga! Neji Ayuga assaulting Yugi! At ringside! What the hell? What the hell is this? And Magician! Magician! Wait a minute! Hiei from behind! Form! Oh my God, a knee strike to Yugi! And Yugi's defenseless! Dark Magician got taken advantage! Hiei once again! Oh no, 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 no! Third eye! Third eye! Oh my God! Is Hiei about to do the impossible? Is he about to do the unthinkable? Oh my God! Oh my God! We've got a new Intercontinental Champion! We have got a new Intercontinental Champion! He has done it! He has finally done it! Neji Ayuga attacking Yugi from out of nowhere, which caused Magician to be distracted and lose sight of his Intercontinental title. And he took advantage of it! And ladies and gentlemen, here tonight at Impulse 96, we have a new Intercontinental Champion! And it's that man, he ain't right there! I'm a little bit in shock and disbelief. After 9 years of failing and choking at every big opportunity that was given to him, here tonight in 2018 on Impulse 96 here in Grand Rapids, Michigan, Hiei has finally obtained singles gold in ACW. Hiei is the new Intercontinental Champion. This crowd cannot believe it. And quite frankly, I can't believe it. I don't even think Hiei can believe it. Hiei is the champion. Impulse number 96. The man that made his return last week on Impulse number 95. He is back and he has returned to ACW Impulse. The legendary Kinnikuman. the legendary King Muscle himself. On a personal level, I'm glad to see Kinnikuman back. I've known Kinnikuman for years, and he was going through a lot during his absence as of late, but to hear him come back is heartwarming to someone like me that has looked up to him ever since he was a kid himself. We're going to take you back to last week on Impulse 95. King JJ was able to defeat Monkey D. Luffy once again on Impulse. Kinnikuman return and save Luffy from any further beating that King JJ was looking to give Monkey D. Luffy. And Kinnikuman sent JJ packing. The last time we saw Kinnikuman on Impulse, King JJ defeated him in his first match here on Impulse. And now we're going to hear from the legend himself. And I cannot wait to hear what he has to say ever since returning back to Impulse. King JJ just got out of the ring here, and Kinnikuman dunked it! Kinnikuman has once again sent JJ out packing! King JJ trying to assault Kinnikuman from behind, but as Kinnikuman stated, he is gonna go down swinging if he has to go down at the Rumble. But we're getting Kinnikuman JJ 2 at the Royale Rumble. And Kinnikuman says that we will get the return of King Muscle at the Royale Rumble, and I can't wait. Wow, what a night, folks. And that has only created the Royale Rumble to be bigger. Our official theme song for the event is Taste for Gold by Jackson Gamble, available on iTunes, Amazon, and other retailers. Let's run down the official Royale Rumble card as it stands right now. First things first from Excel, is Kankuro Sasuke will go one-on-one against a mystery opponent handpicked by Roger Smith, Mr. Smith, if you will. Who is the opponent? And will Ichigo be able to best Roger Smith at the Royale Rumble? For Glamour X action, Juri Sanada, the Glamour X champion, will team up with Reiko Inamoto to take on Inuyamanaka and Ikumimito, two women that have been the bane of Juri and Reiko's existence. Can Juri and Reiko, the dream team in the Glamour X division, take them down? Then also the 30-man XL Rumble match. If you look at the names here, Haru, Akuma, Aang, Night Raid, 2DK, Higashi, Sagat, Soma, and a lot more Falcon over there. Who will become the new XL champion in Chicago? Then on the Impulse side, this is made official just now. King JJ will have to face King Nickaman again at the Royal Rumble. King Muscle is making his return apparently, and he is looking to go down swinging to fight the arrogant and young King JJ. The Impulse Championship is a triple threat match. Kankuro is trading in his Impulse World Wrestling briefcase. And part of this match is Sasuke will defend it against him and Zuko. Can Sasuke escape with another victory, or will the reign of Uchiha end here? And that is the 20-man Impulse World match. The winner of this match will get the golden ticket to challenge for the Impulse Championship at Animania 5 in December. Naruto, Goten, Eren, and you see the likes of Yugo and Rock and Snake and Neji and Luffy all added just recently. Who is walking out with the golden ticket to Animania 5? It's coming to you all live in just a matter of short days and weeks. It's the Royale Rumble in Chicago, Illinois at the United Center. Well, that said, ladies and gentlemen, it is now time for our main event of the Oh my God! Oh my God, okay, all right. Enough from that. I couldn't even do my usual stick. Let's try this again. It's now time for our main event of the evening. There you go, that's how you do it. Damn it. Nonetheless, Kankuro and Gaara head to the ring here. And we know these two are going to be a team here. We know that these two are going to be coexisting. Again, I have not heard any word from Zuko being in the building. So I don't know. Are we getting this tag match? Or is this going to be a handicap match? Or are we getting Sasuke going to get a different partner? I don't know. About to find out in a matter of moments. Well, there's Sasuke, but there is only just Sasuke. Sasuke keeps looking back on stage here. There is no sight of Zuko here. I mean, I don't think Sasuke's really that worried. He'll fight both of them if he wants. He'll fight both of them if he has to. But Sasuke has arrived in the ring here. And yeah, look at this. He's telling the referee he wants to do this alone. Yeah, there we go. So this will be a handicap match. So Sasuke is about to go this alone. Yeah, look at this. And Sasuke, not wasting any time, going after the Puppet Master. And yeah, just as I stated, Sasuke Uchiha, he's had his run into Kankuro and Gaara during this season. He knows what they are. He knows what they're about. He'll fight them alone if he has to. It's not his ideal position, but he'll do it regardless. And there goes Gaara, set off the apron. Same Gaara that returned to Impulse last week and took out Naruto Uzumaki with that sand claw, and now Kankuro sitting on the top rope with that clothesline. Sasuke Uchiha, for the time being, is taking care of Kankuro and Gaara on his own. But that is the type of valor that the Impulse champion would have. Kankuro is finally trading in his Road to Destiny briefcase at the Royale Rumble, a briefcase that he won at Animania 4 last season. He feels that he has more of a chance to win the title than he probably would have facing Sasuke alone. Look at that Northern Lights suplex bridge here. The referee took too much time to get down for the count, and Sasuke able to escape. Oh my God, what a clothesline. What a clothesline. And here's where the numbers game will start to become a bit too much. It will start to become overwhelming for the Impulse champion. And look at this. Oh my God, what a big left. And now Gaara, the legal man of the team here. Sasuke is in an island of his own, and he probably likes it that way, but that's where we're at here. And now look at this, Gaara. Oh, drops him with a neck breaker. And be forewarned, I'll say it if Sasuke won't say it. Sasuke is really still not 100%. After the beating that he took at No Boundaries, he was assaulted by Zuko at the start of that event, and then Zuko continued to assault Sasuke, giving him head trauma. And if it had not been for Kankuro, here's kind of like Gaara one, kicked out by Sasuke at one. If it had not been for Kankuro attempting to trade in that briefcase, Zuko could have been very well on his way to become the new Impulse champion. And I don't try to take that away from Sasuke, but that's the reality of the situation. Kankuro now tagged in. Now gonna try to weaken Sasuke before the Rumble. That's exactly what Kankuro wants if he nails that Russian leg sweep. By the way, did you guys figure out who invented the Russian leg sweep? Comment down below and I will give you a shout out. How about that? This is a mystery to me. I wanna know, was it an actual Russian that created the leg sweep? These are questions that you ask at 5 a.m. when you're bored, folks. Kankuro, multiple clotheslines onto Sasuke to the corner. Shoots the half. One, two. Sasuke able to kick out at two. Gaara will be in the Impulse Rumble match he declared last week as well upon his return. Naruto Uzumaki will be there as well, so you know Gaara will look to do his best to get Naruto out of the Rumble as quick as possible. But we'll see if that will transpire to something big. As Sasuke back up with a nice jawbreaker counter. Kick to the midsection, and Sasuke looking to build back momentum here against Kinnikuman. Kinnikuman with that impassionate speech there earlier before this matchup. Telling King JJ, I might be old, I may not have what it takes like I used to, but damn it, I'm gonna fight you again. If I lose, then I lose. But if I win, that'll prove once and for all that I still got a lot left. And that match will happen at the Royale Rumble. As Gaara with that big knee strike onto the champion. And the Rogue Loner is truly alone at the moment. Kankuro liking what he sees here. Gaara will whip Sasuke to the corner, to the ropes here. Sasuke drops the elbow right onto the arm of Gaara. Kankuro with the kick to the face! Neckbreaker by Gaara! And Sasuke was trying to whip himself to the ropes, but Kankuro broke that up. And there was a rope break by Sasuke to get out of that pin attempt by Gaara. And look, I know Zuko and Sasuke probably wouldn't have gotten along in this tag match regardless, but he needs a tag team partner. This is... Sasuke's trying. But this is going to be a bit much. Gaara now. Hip attack! Towards the champion. And now Gaara sitting over Sasuke. Looking at his work here, if you will. One. Two. And a kick out. Sasuke stays alive in this tag. Well, this handicap match that was originally a tag match. Tonight's the main event here on Impulse number 96. Next week will be Impulse number 97, the go-home show, if you will, of the Royale Rumble. As we take a look at the replay here, Sasuke was going to go for something. Kankuro kicked him, and then that big neckbreaker by Gaara. We're back live here as Kankuro drops the elbow onto Sasuke. As I was trying to say earlier, as Kankuro goes for a cover here. One, two, kick out. Next week will be Impulse 97, the go-home show to the Royale Rumble. It will be Aaron Yeager challenging for Roy once again to the Cruiserweight title. That will be happening next week on Impulse 97. And then after that, and after the Rumble itself, we are going to the UK for XL and Impulse. We'll be having the British Invasion Tour happening. As that will begin the road for Impulse and their road for Impulse number 100 in London, England. Which will be a very supersized episode of Impulse, I'll tell you that right now. Sasuke looking to come back and fight with a nice high angle power slam. Sends down the Puppet Master. And somehow, some way, Sasuke is still fighting. Now Sasuke, from the middle rubble, waits for the Puppet Master to rise up. Double axe handle, sends him down. Sasuke, throughout his entire title reign as Impulse champion, has been fighting against the odds. Whatever that was put in cross of him, whatever that was put in front of him, he was able to rise towards the occasion. And then this Gaara trying to get in here. Look at that, Sasuke! Sasuke detected that Gaara was going to interfere here and is going to take care of him before he seeks any further damage. And down goes the Sand Shinobi! And now look at this. Kankuro, fireman's carry, from the ropes, missed the leaping lariat, from behind with an inverted DDT, and Sasuke Uchiha somehow, some way, has been able to stifle the tandem of Gaara and Kankuro. There's a second, oh no, Kankuro counter, Gaara, no, Sasuke counter the Gaara, holy crap! And now Sasuke, vertical suplex, from the top rope, the Rogue Loner, elbow drop to the dark heart of Kankuro. Somehow, someway, Sasuke, And there's Gaara once again! And Sasuke not going to doubt himself! As Gaara rises up! You're damn right, CKO! For the Sand Demon! But Kankuro from behind is up! Does Sasuke know about it? No, he doesn't! Knee strike to the back! This is not looking good. Elbow by Sasuke. Punch. And look at this, he'll throw him outside. No! No! He faked it! Hangman's DDT coming! Got it! And he nailed it with perfection! Wait a minute! The 7th Hokage! Naruto! Going after Gaara! For some revenge of last week! And you hear the bell! This match is being thrown away here! Naruto's got a chair! Down goes Gaara! CKO! CKO for Kankuro! Sasuke Uchiha has wiped out! Wait a minute! Wait a minute! I just saw Zuko run in the ring! I just saw him in the ring! And Sasuke doesn't know about it! Oh, damn it! And Sasuke just wiped out by Zuko from out of nowhere! And Zuko! Oh, no, no, no! Dancing Dragon! And out goes Kankuro! And that's payback for last week! And it looks like Zuko isn't done here! Oh no, oh no! He's got a table here. He has a table. Oh no, Kankuro's busted open. He just rolled outside and he's busted open. And now Zuko is setting a table here in front of the ring. And Sasuke's nearby. This is not good. We need to get some help here. Oh no, 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 no. What is this? Oh no, no, come on, we are less than 2 weeks for the Rumble, and Zuko is going to take out the Impulse Champion here! Oh my god! Within the smoke and fire, Zuko stands tall tonight! And if that happens at the Rumble, if he's able to take these two out just